Welcome back to MT Creations Creates. Today, we're building the Minecraft-wielding staff from Ellen Becker's Animation vs. Minecraft series. Backstory time! For a long time now, I've been a big fan of Ellen Becker and his stick figure animations. If you've seen my older videos, then you can see a clear influence. In recent times, I've been amazed at how far Ellen Becker has come along since his original AvM video, creating a large, intricate story with an amazing plot. And he did it with Minecraft and stick figures, of all things. At least to me, is it just very impressive how well it's done, and it is an inspiration to me. I absolutely love his king character with a staff that wields Minecraft itself, and I think I'm going to make my own and rule Minecraft or destroy it. So for this creation, I had a couple of options on how to build it. My biggest one is 3D printing it. That was the first option I explored. First, I had to take some measurements. I decided to just go with a simple 1 pixel equals 1 centimeter because the staff is very, well, pixelated. And it actually works for the size that my printer can print at. The only problem is I really want it to be like an actual staff, so it's gonna be tall, it's gonna be big. The staff on the king, it comes up to his shoulder, so I decided to have my staff come up to my shoulder, and it comes up to a good 4'10". I did some simple calculations. I sized things up in Blender. I kind of made a model, a little mock-up if you will, in Blender, and sized it up to the correct proportions. So I figured out that if I wanted to 3D print this thing at 58 inches, then I would have to split it into like about 8 to 10 sections because my printer can only print up to 15 centimeters. So I decided to see how much that would take to print a set of these and how much filament it would take. And I don't think this option is very resource friendly. So I'm gonna make the main staff part out of wood. I'm gonna 3D print the block holder, the blocks, and maybe the end of the staff as well. One big issue I had to figure out is printing the block. At first, my dumbass thought that Minecraft blocks were 8x8 pixels. Of course, I looked back and found out that it was 16x16 pixels, which is a problem because if I'm doing 1 centimeter equals 1 pixel, and my printer can only do 15x15x15 centimeters, yeah, it's a bit of a roadblock. So I'm gonna have to size these blocks down into about 4 8x8x8 centimeter blocks. Same with the holder. I'm gonna have to size that down into parts and build it together. Next step now is to find a good piece of wood, maybe about 1.5 inches all around, and yeah, 4'10" in length. Time to become the new Star Wars kid. So after swinging the stick around like a bumbling idiot, I decided that maybe I can make this a full cosplay. So I decided to make his crown. Thank you. while the crown is currently printing while I'm recording this, I decided to look into how I'm going to get the blocks on the staff to be interchangeable. So I looked into getting some magnets. So I looked on Amazon, and I did find some good magnets that I liked, so I decided to order them. I got the dimensions that were on the website, and I mocked them up in Blender, and I looked into how I'm possibly going to add these magnets. So as I wait for a new spool of filament and the magnets to arrive, I decide to paint the crown, and I measure the wooden staff, and it turns out it's not exactly 4 centimeters by 4 centimeters. Fortunately, it's actually less, so I'm gonna see if I can maybe make a 3D printed cover for the staff. That way it would be 3D printed, but have a wooden filling as to not waste filament and have a very strong interior. And mostly just so I can keep the design at 4x4 centimeters, so it'd be easy to make it perfectly pixelated. This method would still use a lot of filament, but it'd be a lot less filament and a lot less time to make. So in order to test it, I decided to make the end cap for the staff. So I did that. Although I kind of ran into a problem, I tried to recreate this kind of groove-like looking design. Because on the staff, you have these lines on the bottoms and on the top. And they look like they'd be grooves in the staff. And I tried to replicate that, but it didn't really look as good, and it didn't really look as uniform, I guess. And I wanted the staff to look extremely accurate to the actual staff. So for the end cap, I decided to make just one little groove, so you know it's the end of the staff. A little contradictory to what I just said, but I mean, I wanted a groove in there, so I put one in anyway. I went ahead, printed the cap, I liked how it fit, so I went ahead and did the cover as well. And it's coming along well. This turned out to be a great compromise as compared to when I wanted to print the entire thing. Now I have a very sturdy interior and the outer cover that I originally wanted. While I had more covers printing, I decided to work on the Minecraft block mockup that I had previously printed. So I put that together and printed its design. And I put it on the block. So now I have this little mock-up of a Minecraft grass block. Although the final thing will probably have to accommodate for the magnets that I'm going to put in the blocks. So I'll figure that out when we get there. The sleeves on the staff finally finished printing, and it was time to build the top of the staff. And I very quickly got to the place where I had to figure out where to put the magnets in. So I did measurements and accommodated the model to it. And I went on from there. I finally finished the 3D printed structure of the staff and put in the magnets and everything. And then it was time to start building the block and testing things out. So I did, and I went on and I put the magnets in. But the staff wouldn't hold the box in really well. And I printed about like half a block and it still wouldn't hold. So until I could figure something else out, I had to settle for something else. So I tried to make a cardboard mock-up of a block instead. my god, I love it. I love how it feels. It's just a mock-up right now, but it works. It works exactly for what I want. Oh my god. I can destroy Minecraft now.
Alright.
Take a picture. I didn't have a lot of time to finish this staff since going to Spain for the summer was coming in. Which means I'm gonna have to cut this video in half. This will be part one. The staff isn't and won't be finished, but when I come back from the summer, I will make a part two where I finally finish the staff. My plans for the staff are to finish the design on it, make a block that actually works on the staff. I might see if that it'll be still 3D printed, or maybe I'll make cardboard ones. I'm not sure. But my overall plans for the staff are just to make it look like the staff and make the blocks, so hopefully soon I can wield the power of the command block, a gold block. A block of netherite and Minecraft its very self. So that's the staff from Ellen Becker's Animation vs. Minecraft series, part one. I hope you enjoyed this creation so far. I had a lot of fun making this staff, but this creation isn't complete, so we'll have to wait till after summer. Hopefully in the time that summer goes by, this video will get enough attention and it'll motivate me to finish the staff. Which, I mean, of course, knowing me, I'm gonna finish it anyway. But, it'll be some great motivation. And I can't wait to get it done, because wielding Minecraft just sounds like a lot of fun. So, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Please go check out Ellen Becker's animations. They are amazing. He makes Minecraft and stick figures work well. So please, please go check out his stuff. I'll put a link in the description to his channel